where were you when I needed you? I want to tell you.
Jody, how are you?
Well, David, this whole name change thing is going very well. I've gone with one name, as you know.
You started out Simon Le Bon.
Simon Le Bon was my first choice.
And then you went to...
Well, now it's just a one-name thing. Like all the greats, you know, the people who work Vegas, and you only have to see one name on the marquee, a name like Sammy.
Yeah.
Zsa Zsa. I guess maybe that's two.
It's two, actually.
I went with Babbitt, just a one-name thing, and the kids, my friends, my good friends in the Latin community have taken their own lead with it. They're calling me Babito now, which I think is very nice because literally translated it means little Babbitt, and I think that's just perfect. How are you, though?
I'm fine. How's you? Now, I hear wonderful things about the show you're doing again.
Oh, I'm doing a nutty little show. Where
so we'll talk about that. But it's going to be a monster hit, isn't it?
Monster hit. Yeah. We're opening up tomorrow night at the Bottom Line Club in town. The show's called Leader of the Pack. Tribute to the music of Ellie Greenwich, a fabulous songwriter from the 60s, and she's still happening now. And she wrote things like Be My Baby to Duran Run.
There's not even a small part in this for me, is
for
there?
For you?
It's just could I walk
no, there's
on?
Nothing for you.
Nothing for me.
I play the comedy lead. I do a sort of a tour de force in the thing, the comedy lead.
All right. Well, congratulations to you, Paul. And I'm looking forward to seeing that. It's very
fingers
exciting.
Crossed on that.
You can have a good weekend?
The weekend's coming up.
Yeah, you can have a good one.
Am I going to have a good? Yeah, well, we're opening up this very nutty show. It's called, I already spoke about it. Leader of the Pack.
Some kind of odd time warp in here. Yeah. It all started with, what's his name? Dong Boy up there. Oh, no, wait a minute. We'll be having Dr. Ruth Westheimer on the show. Now, I'm leaving something out, aren't I? That's it? Gee, does it still seem like two shows? Do what? Oh, of course, viewer mail. Yeah, that's right. It's Thursday. So now say hello to our friend Paul, and let's get this thing underway.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
That it is.
I think it's... boy, thank you very much. Hot tracking. I think it stacks up to about 1.5.
1.5 shows?
Great shows. Good.
But it will be great. It's going to be a solid show.
Solid show. Those chairs, we go backwards, of course.
Yeah. It'll be exciting to do.
Just straight into the wall.
Your arm okay?
Looking forward to it. Yeah, boy, have I had... Let me just say, if I could take a minute to tell a true, absolutely true story.
As long as it's true, Paul.
You know, I'm doing that nutty Ellie Greenwich show, Leader of the Pack at the Bottom Line.
Yeah.
Playing just like this constantly, because that's the type of music it is. I developed tendonitis, and I was just going nuts, really. Couldn't play until Candy, our makeup gal, Candy Carell, she says, you're playing those eighth notes wrong, babe. I said, what do you mean? She says, well, she's a pianist, and she explained, you got to keep the wrist loose. Started doing that, Candy, and my problems are over. I can now play two shows a night, different things, running. Candy saved my, she saved my career. That's all I can say. That gorgeous blonde in the dark.
Now, is that show sold out? If people want to buy tickets, can they still go see you down there?
Gee, probably? I don't know. It's a very hot ticket in town,
right.
You know.
All right. I'm coming down there.
I know.
Last night on this program, everywhere I go, people tell me what a great hit your show is.
You got to come down.
I'm coming down. Thursday, we're coming down. You going to have a good weekend?
I intend to. Well, I'm going to be working, you know.
Oh, that's right. This is the last weekend, though, before...
Last weekend down at the Bottom Line for the...
Well, have a nice weekend.
Show, yeah.
Tonight is Thursday night, and in addition to all the other wonderful things we have planned, it's viewer mail night.
Let me just tidy up here, and then we'll get the show off. There we go. Okay, we're all set now? Robert Klein is here tonight, the man with the world's strongest teeth, Joe Ponder, and the lovely Jane Seymour. All of this and much, much more after you take a look at these shows. Welcome back. Robert Klein is here, Jane Seymour, and Joe Ponder, the man with the world's strongest teeth. Fascinating gentleman. What's the name of the song, Paul? I keep asking, and I'm sorry, I can't remember it.
Christmas Baby, Please Come Home.
Yeah.
It's recorded by Darlene Love.
Great song.
I think we should get her on the show maybe next week and do it as this kind
of
an all-time
year. Sounds
here.
Terrific. And,
thank you.
Good. Our first guest tonight. See, I don't know.
You very much.
It doesn't make any difference.
I don't know either.
All right.
right, this is going to be great. In 1963, my next guest recorded a song called Christmas Baby, Please Come Home. It was that very first rock and roll Christmas hit ever. Yeah, and has been released as a single every year since. It is also one of the most popular tunes on this legendary album right here, Phil Spector's Christmas album. There it is, right there. Ladies and gentlemen, here singing it tonight with our band, please welcome the one and only Darlene Love. Yeah! We'll do a commercial and be right back. Sounded very nice. Okay, nice to have you here. That sounds great. You know, Paul plays that every year, and I keep saying, what is that song, what is that song? And so this year he came and sang it. It was wonderful.
Great.
Nice to have you here. Everything nice okay with you?
Everything is wonderful.
Thanks for being here. Come back and sing it again next year.
Of course.
I hope you have a good holiday. My thanks to the folks who were here tonight, Jay Leno, Pam Shriver, and, of course, Darlene Love. Tomorrow, folks, on the program, Australian cowgirl Sandy Thorne, Rick Moranis, and Jeff Cesario. Bring a covered dish, won't you? Thank you very much. Good night, everybody. Anne and Nancy Wilson asking the musical holiday question, Barracuda? Our next guest is a wonderful singer who 30 years ago recorded the only rock and roll Christmas song that I truly enjoy. Here now to sing Christmas Baby Please Come Home, our good friend Darlene Love. Here she is. Come on up. Thank you. Darlene Love, folks. We'll be right back. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, have a lovely holiday. Thank you very much for watching. Good night, everybody. Merry Christmas. Gentlemen, when you get right down to it, there really are only two holiday traditions that I truly, truly look forward to. One, of course, is dressing up my kitty like Santa. And the other is a visit from our next guest. And next month, she appears at the Rainbow and Stars right here in New York City. Do me a favor, please welcome Darlene Love. years have you done that for us?
Goes
way back,
years.
Doesn't it? It's a great song, and you sound terrific. You're going to be at Rainbow and Stars, and it'll be a nice... You know, Darlene, could I just suggest maybe a little Head and Shoulders?
Oh, okay. You can suggest it.
Okay. My thanks to Darlene Love and everybody in the big band. Man, did you guys sound good?
Yes!
Thank you very much. My thanks also to Mike Judge and Rosie O'Donnell. We'll see you on Monday. Have a very Merry Christmas. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Thanks, brother. Thanks, man.
folks, it's time for something really exciting. You know, every year we do this. Our next guest comes on the program to perform the one and only Christmas rock and roll song that we actually enjoy. She's currently appearing in That's Christmas at the Schubert Theater in Chicago through January 5th. Ladies and gentlemen, we're always happy to have her here, Darlene Love. Hey, darling, you should have been here earlier. We flipped the negative. Oh, man. As far as I'm concerned, the best thing about the holiday season is when our next guest takes the stage for what is now an annual late show tradition, currently appearing at Rainbow and Stars here in New York City through January 3rd. Please welcome Darlene Love. Enjoy doing this. We do it every year, and every year it gets better and better and better. It's always very thrilling to have these great voices and great musicians and great music right here, and tonight I think it's going to be something extra special. Our next guest, a legendary performer whose recent autobiography is called My Name is Love. She also has a new gospel CD. Boy, hosting a show is hard. I got to hold this stuff up. A new gospel CD entitled Unconditional Love. Please welcome now, along with very special guests, Sissy Houston, Roberta Flack, and Phoebe Snow, the lovely Darlene Love. Here we go.
Darlene, I'm glad. Good to see you. Darlene Love,
everybody.
Thank you. Let me love back, kids.
Paul, that was weird. That was very strange. It was great music, but the snowstorm seemed to be very, very isolated.
Isolated snowstorms.
Yeah. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. My thanks to Darlene Love, Sissy Houston, Roberta Flack, Phoebe Snow, of course, John Travolta, and everybody else who was here. Have a great holiday season, and enjoy yourself. Drive safely. We'll see you soon. Good night, everybody.
Yours in Pants.
Our next guest is a legendary singer whose holiday visits to this program are a tradition here. Joining her tonight, the High Bridge Voices, a youth choir from the Bronx. Ladies and gentlemen, Darlene Love, let's go!
Please. pretty good, Paul. Thank you very much. Nice job. Merry Christmas to you and everybody.
She kills that song every year.
Absolutely. My thanks to Darlene Love, John Witherspoon, and Hallie Eisenberg. Now, tomorrow, here's a program reminder. The Late Show, we will not be on because tomorrow is Christmas Eve. And normally they have midnight mass from like St. Patrick's or St. Peter's. But CBS this year instead is not having that. They're trying out a game show. You know, like that Regis thing was such a huge deal.
I see.
They're just going to sneak one in and give
Christmas
it a shot.
Christmas Eve.
Yeah, that's
right.
Try
it out.
Merry Christmas. We'll see you Monday. Good night, everybody.
Nice pants, Kenny.
You know, it's a tradition around here at the Late Show to have our next guest bring in the holidays, and joining her tonight are the United States Air Force Singing Sergeants. Ladies and gentlemen, Darlene Love. You ready, Paul?
All right. If you ask me, the best thing about the holidays is the visit from our next guest, who is nice enough to come on the show every year and do this for us. You'll be able to see this woman at the Danny Kaye Playhouse right here in Manhattan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, get ready. Hang on to something. Please welcome Darlene Love. Darlene Love.
And better than ever.
My thanks to Darlene Love, Reese Evans, and, of course, Jamie Foxx. We'll see you tomorrow night with Marissa Tomei and Jay Thomas. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Biscuits and gravy.
Go. For my money, the best thing about the holidays is a visit from our next guest, and tomorrow night she'll be performing at New York's Symphony Space. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the program, Darlene Love.
Oh, Yes, sir. How good is that? Nice to see you.
God bless you. Merry Christmas.
Darlene Love, everybody. We'll be right back. Wonderful. That was just great. I love that. How many years have you been doing that here?
This will be the 18th year.
18th year. Oh, my God. Is that right?
Got to do something for the 20th year.
That's fantastic. Well, it was just lovely. It's always a very nice highlight for the holidays. Good to see you again.
Thank you
very much. My thanks also to Liv Tyler, the paratroopers from Fort Bragg, North Carolina, and Jay Thomas. I guess there's nothing we can do about that. Monday on the program, Kelly Ripa, Emmett Smith, and Missy Elliott. I smell a rerun. Have a lovely weekend. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
The Late Show is a production of Worldwide Pants Incorporated. This is Alan Carter saying good night and drive safely.
Oh, Santa.
Hi, how you doing? My name's Sergeant Stephen Grancy from 1AD Engineer Brigade. I just want to say a big I love you to my twins, Courtney and Stephen, and to everybody in Ohio, Amy, Tom, Bobby, and Jessica. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Love you all.
Very sweet. Very nice. Thanks to all of the folks over there making the world a better place. You know, around here, it's certainly not Christmas until we get a visit from our next guest, and she is currently appearing in the 20th anniversary All-Star Tour of Nonsense. Ladies and gentlemen, a great delight to have her here. Say hello to Darlene Love. What?
Christmas.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Darlene. Always a pleasure. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. Darlene Love, everybody. Merry Christmas. We'll be right back. Thank you, folks. Good to see you.
Hey, my name is Specialist Nicole McWhite. I'm with 354 Civil Affairs Brigade, 1st Armored Division. I'd just like to say happy holidays to my friends and family in Greensboro, North Carolina, especially to my mama, Edith Krista. I love you, mama.
Thank you, everybody. How about that for a little Christmas present? The great Darlene Love, ladies and gentlemen. My thanks also to Renee Zellweger and, of course, the men and women of the Army's 1st Armored Division in Baghdad. My thanks also to Jay Thomas. And that's it for us. Have a great holiday season. We'll see you soon. Good night, everybody.
The Late Show is a production of Worldwide Pants Incorporated. This is Hammond Carter saying good night and drive safely.
Oh, Santa.
Much. Our next guest has been part of our Late Show Christmas tradition for more than a decade, and it wouldn't be the holidays without her. Ladies and gentlemen, here's our good friend Darlene Love.
Oh,
wonderful as always. God bless you. Thank you very much. Darlene Love, everybody. Merry Christmas.
I'm Sergeant Garcia from Tracy, California. I want to tell my wife and my daughters happy holidays. I love you guys. Miss you guys.
Very nice. By the way, thanks to all of the men and women appearing on the program tonight, stationed in Kirkuk, Iraq. Good luck to them and Godspeed. And how about Darlene Love? As you said, Paul,
year better after than... year, it turns it out.
And Bruce Kapler. In the big surprise box, and he's been in there like all day, right?
He had to stay.
I saw it in the hallway. I had no idea he was in there.
I know. Isn't that something?
And what about the snow? I mean, this year I think we were actually using larger chunks of asbestos than usual.
That's just that. I got some caught right down in here. I feel great.
My thanks also to Jay Thomas, probably expendable after what happened tonight.
Well, oh, no, don't say that.
And Regis Philbin, tomorrow it's Midnight Mass, and Monday Howard Stern and Alanis Morissette. Merry Christmas. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Oh, Santa.
Thank you very much. This is going to be lovely. Oh, Paul, I know you're very busy. Is that a French horn? Are we looking at a French horn there?
Yes, sir. That is a French horn.
Oh,
yes.
This is tremendous.
He puts his hand in it like this.
Yeah. In a muff.
That's...
something...
In a manner of speaking, yeah.
It wouldn't be Christmas without a visit from our next guest. She's currently starring in Hairspray on Broadway. Please welcome back our good friend, Darlene Love.
Thank you. Darlene Love, what a tremendous voice. Just better and better. Beautiful. Darlene Love, Paul Shaffer, CBS Orchestra. We'll be right back.
Nice job. Absolutely. Better and better every year. Tremendous, Paul. Thank you very much. Thank you, Bruce. But how great is Darlene Love?
Better and better.
How great is Darlene
Love? Every year she's better.
God
bless. She
gets
better. Keeps getting better.
That's tremendous. My thanks to Darlene Love, Rosie Perez, Jay Thomas, and the men and women of the United States Armed Forces. Monday, Howard Stern and Pharrell. Thanks for watching. Have a great holiday. Good night, everybody.
Oh, Santa.
We would like to wish our fellow Alaskans and especially our friends and families.
Happy holidays!
There you go. Those people are over there doing that so we can be here doing this. Doesn't seem fair. Well, it wouldn't be a Christmas without a visit from our next guest. She is currently appearing in Hairspray on Broadway. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back the delightful Darlene Love.
Darlene Love. Hello, Darlene.
Merry Christmas.
Darlene Love, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. We'll be right back, everybody. The wonderful Darlene Love. You sounded great, Paul. Everybody sounded tremendous.
How about Darlene? Thank you, Darlene.
My thanks to Darlene Love, Kate Blanchett, and Jay Thomas. Merry Christmas. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Oh, Santa.
The best thing about the holidays, a visit from our next guest, is she's appearing now at the Raz Room in San Francisco from December 27th through January 4th. That's a great show. Go see that. Ladies and gentlemen, please back it. Welcome back the one, the only Darlene Love, everybody. Hello, Darlene.
Hello.
Great.
Nice. Always a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Darlene Love, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, everybody.
Merry Christmas. Good night, folks. It's all yours.
Oh, Santa.
Hey, Katie. Hey, Alicia. Especially Jeffrey Benson. Just wishing you guys a happy new year and a Merry Christmas all the way from Kyle Spiker, Iraq to Corydon, Indiana.
It's officially Christmas here at The Late Show when our next guest pays us a visit. Her original 1963 recording of this holiday song has just been reissued. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the program the lovely Darlene Love.
Great job. Thank you, Bruce. Merry Christmas, everybody. Thank you. Good night, folks.
Oh, Santa.
Hi, my name is Lance Corporal Richard Valerius, currently deployed in Afghanistan. I'm from Casper, Wyoming. I'd like to give a shout out to my family and friends. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, and I love you and I'll see you soon.
Thank you. Each year, one of the things we look forward to at the holidays at The Late Show is a visit from our next guest, and she was recently named as a 2011 Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductee. We couldn't be happier for her. Well deserved. It's her new live CD. It's entitled The Concert of Love. Please welcome back Darlene Love, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, I'm Tech Sergeant Kevin Olson with the 70th Medium Truck Detachment out of Camp Air John Kuwait. We'd like to wish everybody back home a happy holiday.
Happy holidays!
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, and very nice. Tonight marks the 25th anniversary of a favorite holiday tradition here at The Late Show, featuring our next guest. Earlier this year, this woman was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the remarkable Darlene Love.
Please come.
everybody. Merry Christmas. How you doing, sweetheart?
Wonderful.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Same
thank
to you.
And thank you so much. Thank you, Paul. Very nice. Darlene Love, everybody. Have a great Christmas. Good night, Debbie.
Hi, this is Captain Gable F. Hackman, stationed out in Kabul, Afghanistan. Just wanted to wish a happy holidays to my sister-in-law and her husband. Hey, Rebecca. Hey, Patrick. Hope you guys are having a great holiday season. Miss you guys, and I'll see you real soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd have to say that one of my favorite things about the holiday season is our next guest, and tomorrow night, she'll be performing at the New Jersey Performing Arts Center with her annual Christmas show. Please welcome back for our annual Christmas show, the lovely Darlene Love. Thank you very much. There you go. Merry Christmas, everybody. Thank you. Come on, baby, come on.
Santa.
Hi, my name is IS2 Janice Mason, coming at you from Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. I just want to wish my husband, James Mason, a happy holidays, and I miss him, miss him, miss him, and in Cabot, Arkansas.
Gitmo. Hello, Darlene. By the way, here, a lot of people calling in wanting to get a look at the meatball. There it is. It's a beauty, isn't it? It's a Douglas fir. We've been lucky enough to have this woman celebrate Christmas with us and for us for 20 years, ladies and gentlemen. She stars in and is featured on the soundtrack of the acclaimed film 20 Feet from Stardom, currently available on iTunes and next month on DVD. Do me a favor, please welcome Darlene Love.
Yeah.
Oh, Santa.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next guest first performed her holiday classic on our show 28 years ago, wow, back at the other network, and it's been an annual tradition, and we all look forward to it. So, say hello to Darlene Love. Darlene. Good to see you. How are you doing?
I'm great.
We'll get right through this because I know you're in a wedding. how you doing?
I'm great.
What can you tell me about this song and your connection to it from the beginning before we got to you? What was the connection there?
You know what? The David Letterman show started this connection.
Is that right?
Because I didn't sing that song that much. Mm-hmm. I really started my solo career at 40. When I moved to New York, and wow, when Paul was in Leader of the Pack, mm-hmm, and we sung the song.
Oh, by gosh, I remember that. Downtown.
You came to the show.
Yeah.
And you said, that's the greatest Christmas song I ever heard.
Right.
And the more we did it on the show, mm-hmm, the more people wanted me to do it.
Well, it's become, I can't speak for others, but for me, it's become very meaningful. And to see you and working with Paul is really a blessing to have this great music and then the combination. It's wonderful.
Every year. It's been fantastic every year.
It's amazing. You know how you always quote it wrong? I've been talking about this show. I've had so many interviews, and it's been said that when the show closes, I'm never singing this song again. that's crazy.
No,
I said that I would never sing it again on another show.
Oh, well, and thank you very
you'll
much.
You'll be the only.
Well, God bless
this
you.
This is where it will end.
Thank
but
you.
I will
you
sing the song again.
I think I would like to sing it myself.
I think you should join us.
I think absolutely. What not? Maybe not tonight. So when we come back, ladies and gentlemen, it'll be Darlene Love. Come on back, everybody. You get a show, try to do this every now and then. And now, ladies and gentlemen, performing her holiday classic for us, our good dear friend, Darlene Love.
Darlene Love, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Shaffer. Thank you, everybody. Thank you so much. It's been a great pleasure. God bless you, my dear. Thank you for watching. Good night, everybody.
Since I started working for him in 1982 and always was dying to play the Monster Mash on Halloween, David Letterman has explained to me over and over again, I hate novelty records, and mostly I hate holiday novelty records. But somehow his taste in music and mine come together on this one particular Christmas. Yes, I'll say it, novelty record. Darlene Love's Christmas, Baby, Please Come Home. And somehow he gradually fell into this tradition of doing it every year. He loves it every year, and he's so supportive of it every year. The day starts with the rehearsal of the background vocals, which is a sort of a Phil Spector gospel choir backing her up. Again, you know, singers that I've used over and over again through these years, and everybody knows it. But every year, you know, we get a little closer to the Holy Grail, which is the original recording. Reproducing it, trying to reproduce that same feeling. A couple of us, Ula Hedwig and Annie Golden, appeared in the Leader of the Pack show with me and Darlene. And these girls are Darlene's favorites. She always wants to have them in the background. I mean, I've been working with them all since the 70s. Many of the group come from the Luther Vandross school of background singing, and there is no higher degree than, you know, than that one. And Darlene knows all of these people very well.
So guys, you're sort of gathering around the bar. You're on this side of the stage, you're sort of leaning up on this, some behind.
For rehearsal, you can do a breakaway.
Uh-huh.
And then we have one, so we have two. We have one for rehearsal, one for the show.
We've been doing this number with Darlene on the show, recreating her tune from the Phil Spector Christmas album, which first came out in 1963. And all of my musicians know this pretty well by now, but we learn something every year, something new.
Let's try it. One. Yeah. Here we go. Strings up, horns up. All right, here we go. One, two. A one, two, three, and.
Every year we try to get it a little bit more authentic, a little bit closer to the original, whether it be to finally arrive at the correct number of horns from the original. You know, I got Tom Malone, who writes the arrangement for me each year, analyzes it with a graphic equalizer and sees, you know, does he hear, you know, is it his imagination, or is he hearing that fourth trombone? You know, well, that's how seriously we take it. You can't improve on perfection. That original, Phil Spector, A Christmas Gift for You, this tune featuring Darlene Love.
About 24 years ago, I was doing a show at a club here in New York called The Bottom Line, and we were doing a show called Leader of the Pack, and Paul Shaffer was playing Phil Spector, and he invited David Letterman down to see the show. One night on the air, David asked Paul, you know that song that girl sang, something about a Christmas song? That's the greatest Christmas song I've ever heard. We need to get her on our show. And from that day to this day, I have been singing that song. Most of these singers I've worked with before over the years, not just with Paul Shaffer on the David Letterman show, we see each other at recording sessions over the years, so we're like a family, and it's usually the same group of people every year because everybody wants to do this show every year. It's amazing, and it's the same with the musicians.
Every year, we think of a way to reveal Bruce Kapler as he plays the famous saxophone solo from the record, note for note. To me, that's another hallowed rock and roll tradition.
I remember one time he came out of the ceiling, just flying out of the ceiling. He came out of a box. He came out of a chair.
He burst through a fireplace like Santa coming down, and I thought he looked very spiffy in a brand new red suit and red Superfly hat, as any Santa worth his salt in a song like this should look.
They're not telling me this time what he's doing. You know, now they're trying to surprise me. So now they don't even tell me now what he's doing.
One cool thing I love about Darlene is, although she comes from the gospel tradition primarily, still, she refers to herself not as a gospel singer, not as an R&B singer, but she calls herself proudly a rock and roll singer. And that's why I was so gassed when I found out that she has been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Because she is, Darlene Love is rock and roll.
I can't wait!
You're rocking again.
Quite unique, I think, in show business to have a singer like Darlene Love who gets better and better. Who knows how old she was when she made this record? 19, probably. And here she is, you know, all these years later, as she has not missed a beat since then. So every year it's just a musical gas as well as everything else. I couldn't be more thrilled.
The best thing about the holidays, a visit from our next guest here now to sing Christmas, Baby, Please Come Home, our good friend Darlene Love. Let's go.
Christmas. Paul Shaffer. How about that? How about them guys? Nice job. Thank you for watching. Merry Christmas, everybody.